mentioned rebirth or finding, shining your light through really dark times or dark that feels like it's closing in. It feels a little awkward to follow a song and to follow that really beautiful song. We were talking about perspective and transforming. Anyway, the song is written as an antidote to divorce, and that feels a little trivial to me right now, but maybe that's good. Problems are not. But it's also really just about being who we really are and how hard that can be sometimes. How many illusions it's easy to believe.
You are light, even when all the darkness is. document called The New American Century, and it was about the idea of what strategies would have to take place for the United States to control the world, not just for now, but for always. And of course, that would take control of all the natural resources. And they determined that the first one, of course, given the global dependence on oil, would be oil. So they were going to, their proposal was to establish the United States dominance by first controlling the oil market and supply, and then moving on to water, and so on and so forth. And there was one piece in that document that struck me, where they said, in order to actually get the people of the United States to get behind that kind of global dominance paradigm of thought, then it would make sense that we had to convince them that was a noble cause. And so something like Pearl Harbor would do well for us to serve our cause. And then, of course, we had a terrible tragedy in New York on September 11th, and it seemed to suit that purpose, and shortly thereafter, we were in war in the Middle East trying to acquire power in that region where they had a lot of oil. So, I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but certainly that piece of information struck me as worth thinking about. And I also really loved, so when I was a little kid, I played football for a local football team called the North End Bulldogs. And we had this, team cheer. We are Bulldogs, we like Bulldogs. Everywhere you go, people want to know who we are, so we tell them. And I thought that, in my view, kind of represented this global dominance idea. And so I worked that into the bridge of the song. George W. Bush was someone who was himself not committed enough to United States military involvement to actually serve in the military, but he was a cheerleader in college. So good for him. He definitely learned how to work the megaphone and try and sway the masses in his direction.
Just for me. And what about a cowboy afraid to shoot? He said, I'll take the cash and the glory and get the poor to do the dying for me. And pose for your photos in working boots. So look out for your chicken hawk and his entire flock. Boy, what a double talker. He said, I wanna go down in history, pop up a new US century, not for a time, but for all the time. In order to create our dominion, we gotta shake the sheep's opinion. Another Pearl Harbor will suit us fine. So look out for your chicken hawk and his entire flock. We are the Bulldogs, wasn't so hard, was it? The cheerleader's bullhorn does it. Everybody's with or against us now. So look out for your chicken hawk and his entire flock.
Even that one. live in like over 10 years.
I tend to do a lot of meditation and stuff, so lately I've been really like messing around with being more honest with myself and my situations and where I'm at now as a person. And this song is called You Say, and it's really about trust and feeling insecure. And I had this guitar riff going around for a while, and a chord progression, and I really didn't know what to do with it. I was like having a lot of emotions, and then somebody said something to me, and it immediately all just came together, and I wrote from there. But here it goes.
Bye.
And then
next week. Oh, once again for you, here I kneel. Hurry, say the words, so I am here. Let's get to the wine.
Started writing this, and the chorus were lyrics that I was sitting on for a while.